Hi everyone, this is Rajasekhar from CK College of Engineering and Technology. I am going to give you a video lecture on algebra and number theory. Today we are going to see the first unit, groups and rings. The main objective of this paper is to introduce the basic notions of groups, rings, fields, which will then be used to solve related problems. Also to understand the basic concepts in number theory. Right, we move on to the first unit, groups and rings. Before going to start the session, I would like to recollect the definition of a group. If G is a non-empty set and dot is a binary operation on G, then G comma dot is called a group. If it satisfies the following four conditions, closure condition, associative, identity, as well as inverse. Along with the four conditions, one more condition, commutative, A dot B that equal to B dot A means the group G dot is called an abelian group. An important theorem, statement of the theorem is if H, K are subgroup of G, then H intersection K is also a subgroup of G. Be enough to prove H intersection K is non-empty set as well as any two element from H intersection K that inverse also exist in the same group. Since H, K are subgroups of G, based on the subgroup definition, H definitely satisfies the four conditions, particularly identity element should exist. Similarly, K should satisfy all the four conditions. Also identity element, I would like to take element identity element E from H as well as in K. Therefore, the same element E exists in H and K means definitely H intersection is a non-empty, that is not equal to 5. Let A comma B belongs to H intersection K, then definitely A comma B belongs to H and A comma B belongs to K. Hence, subgroup definition A B inverse belongs to H, also A B inverse belongs to K. The same element exists in H as well as in K. Definitely A B inverse belongs to H intersection K. From the two, we conclude H intersection K is a subgroup of G. So move on to the example. Show that the set of rigid motions of a square with a binary operation of composition is a non-abelian group. So we form one set F. We should show this is a group but not an abelian group. So there are 8 rigid motions will happen of square. I will show you a table. F1, F2, F3, up to F8. These are the 8 functions. The rigid motions will happen in square. Rigid motion before and after, and last one is the permutations of vertices. Here F1 is identity. There is no motion happen. So before and after are looking same. Therefore, permutations of vertices 1 with 1, 2 with 2, 3 with 3, and 4 with. And second motion is F2 90 degree clockwise. 1 goes to 2 and 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4 and 4 goes to 1. Clockwise rotation. Therefore, 1 replaces by 4, 2 replaces by 1, 3 replaces by 2 and 4 replaces by 3. Similarly, F3 rotates 180 degree clockwise. That is, first place goes to third one, second place goes to fourth place, likewise motions will happen. Therefore, 1 replaced by 3, 2 replaced 4, and 3 replaced 1, 4 replaced 2. Likewise, we proceed all the F8. Here, F5 is reflect 1 and 2. The interchange the area. 1 is replaced by 2 and 2 is replaced by 1. Likewise, we collect the permutations of vertices for all the function f 8. Now we are going to see the composition table. How to formulate the composition table? Here one example is given, f3 dot f4 that is equal to how we multiply or how we dot product the permutations. f3 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 1, 2, and f4 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1. Here, first permutation 1 goes to 3, and in the second, 3 goes to 4. So, 1 goes to directly 4, and 2 goes to 4, 4 goes to 1, then 2 directly goes to 1. Likewise, you proceed, the new permutation is nothing but f2, that is f2 is 1 2 3 4 4 1 2 3. So likewise we formulate the composition table, f4 along with f8, f8 along with f8, f1 f2. Likewise we formulate, these are the table shows there is no new functions related. All are existing in capital F. So the composition of table gives the closed property exist. Associative, we are moving to the check associative property. If we take any three functions f8, f3 and f6, first we permutation, dot permutation will happen f3 and f6. There is f3 with f6, what gives f5. So f5, here f5 mentioned, and f8 with f5, f8 with F5 that gives F4. Similarly, F8 of F3, F8 of F3 gives F7, and then F7 with F6 gives F4. Therefore, associative property is also proved. Also, identity is F1. Identity is f1. Also inverse also existing for all the functions. F1 inverse is f1, f2 inverse is f4. How we find f2 corresponding with f4 mean that gives identity f1. Also f4 inverse is f2, f4 inverse is f2, that is f1. Likewise we get. So conclude that all the closure, associative and identity inverse existing for capital F. Therefore F comma dot is a group. F comma dot is a group. So we check the commutative, f5 dot f2 that gives f8, f5 dot f2 that gives f8. Similarly, let me check f2 dot f5. f2 dot f5 that gives f7. So f7 is not equal to f8. Clearly, commutative is not true. Hence, f dot is not an abelian group. So next move on to the important theorem, Lagrange's theorem. Before going to start, we would like to give one definition, left coset and right coset. If H is a subgroup of G, then for each A belongs to G, the set A capital H equal to AH such that H belongs to capital H is called a left coset. As well as the right coset, capital H A equal to small h A such that small h belongs to capital H is a type process. So Lagrange's theorem statement, if G is a finite group of order n and H is a subgroup of order m, means m divides n. We have to prove order of H divides order of G. Even since G is a finite group, means H is a subgroup of G, definitely based on the note, a subgroup of finite group is finite. Definitely H is also a finite group. Therefore, it may be finite, means number of cosets should finite. Therefore, the number of cosets of H in G is finite. Let HA1, HA2, HAR be the distinct right cosets of G, of H in G. Then by the right cosets decomposition of G, the main group capital G is union of right cosets HA1 union HA2 HAR. Let we take the order from on both sides. Order of G is equal to order of H1 plus order of union. Here union is goes to addition. While we take the order of H1 plus order of HA2 plus order of HAR. But we know that order of H1 equal to order of HA2 order of HAR, that equal to order of H, based on the note already you see. So we replace the value, order of G is equal to order of H1 is equal to order of H, likewise order of H plus order of H. So number of order of H is R into order of H. Therefore clearly shows order of H divides order of G, hence M divides N. Thank you. We will see you in the next video. Thank you.